Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and welcome to another Onshape quick tip, where today we're going to talk about the new thin feature option for extrude, which was just added in the 1.162 release. Now, there's a lot to be said about this option, and I'm just going to give you a brief overview, but the biggest thing I want to tell you is that this is now functionality that is available in Onshape. So I'm very excited to see this functionality being added. Let's take a look at how it works here. I'm going to start a new sketch here on the front plane, going to create a line that comes over, come back and touch the endpoint, come around with a tangent arc, another new bit of functionality that was added in 1.162. And now that I've got that geometry in place there, I'm going to turn it into an extrusion. So we can see here, we've got solid extrusion, surface extrusion, and now thin extrusion. So just like the other features in Onshape, the other extrude tools in Onshape, I can go through and I can click the elements that I want to include in this extrusion. I can control the depth of the extrusion and whether or not it's going to be a midplane or a symmetric extrusion, all the same options that we're used to in the extrude command. But what's new is here, I can control what the wall thickness is of that extrusion. If I want to, I can have it go in two different directions. So we could say it's going 5 millimeters in a different direction. And we can also include options like draft. So this could get gradually thicker or gradually thinner as that thin feature extrudes. Very cool stuff, and I am very excited to see that this is now available in Onshape. So let's take a look at a practical design here. We're going to take a look at this part, which is called pivot. And we can see if we look at the 2D drawing that we're now challenged to create this section of the pivot. Well, this might be a great place to work with this new thin feature functionality. So we're going to create a 50 by 50 millimeter square with a 10 millimeter wall thickness. So we'll select this face, begin a sketch. We will jump into the rectangle command. Remember, when you're creating a rectangle, if you hold the Alt key, it will be a square. So when I single click here, I can let go of the Alt key and then I can type in the 50 dimension and it becomes equal on both sides of that square. Very useful shortcut there. Now I'm gonna jump into the extrude command. I'm gonna say this is gonna be a thin feature extrude. I'll click within this perimeter and we can see that we then get the thin feature for all the elements of that contour. Now we're going to flip the direction of the thin feature and make it 10 millimeters. And we're going to say that that has a depth of 60 millimeters. And there we go. To finish this thing off, all we need to do is blast this square through. So I'll just select that face there, S key extrude, turn that into a remove. And I'll say that I want that to go through all. And that is a great practical application of that new thin feature. What do you guys think? Were you waiting for this thin feature to be available in Onshape? Are you as excited as I am that thin feature is now available? This is very cool stuff. And if you agree, let me know down in the comments below. Of course, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to join us for the next episode.